Good morning, everyone. It is a couple minutes after 8 o'clock. I am running a little tiny bit late this morning, but I'm here and ready for our Wednesday morning meditation. Pepper's here, ready to meditate with us. So when you're here, just let me know and we'll get started. This morning, we'll be doing what we have been doing. So we'll start with our breath work and then move into the inspirational reading and then our guided meditation for the day. The breath work is on four counts. So we do four counts, inhale and then hold, four counts, exhale, and then hold for four counts, and then we repeat. If you're new to the breath work today, you just do as many counts as it feels right to you without feeling panicked with your breath or feeling like you're restricting your breath. I like to do the counts on an affirmation, so I'm going to use affirmations in four counts. And we'll do the first three rounds together and the second three rounds on our own, and then we'll meet back for our inspirational reading for the day. All right, good morning, guys. Good morning, Keely. All right, Pepper. Pepper's just waiting to lay down on my lap here. So finding a comfortable seat for yourself, something that you can sustain for a few moments. Excuse me, sir. And then just beginning to allow your eyes to close. Just having your hands in a receptive position on your lap. And sitting up as tall as you can. Just beginning to notice the natural rhythm of your breath. Noticing the length of your inhale, the length of your exhale. And you can notice, are they the same length? Are they different lengths? Beginning to notice. Notice where your breath sits in your body. Do you feel your breath in your chest? Do you feel your breath in your belly? Where in your body do you feel your breath? Just observing and noticing, not trying to change anything. Just practicing being an observer. Take a full breath in together, and then we'll easefully exhale out, and we'll begin our affirmative breath work. We'll do three rounds together and three rounds on our own, and you can count your breath or use any affirmation you like for those. So we'll take an inhale breath, easefully exhale out, and then inhale. Divine life lives me, and whole. Divine life lives me, and exhale. Divine life lives me, and whole. Divine life lives me, and inhale. Perfect peace fills me, and whole. Perfect peace fills me. And exhale, perfect peace fills me, and whole, perfect peace fills me. And inhale, divine health lives me, and whole, divine health lives me. Exhale, divine health lives me and whole. Divine health lives me. And moving into three more rounds on your own time with an affirmation or counting your breath. Just finishing up this last round on your own time. And moving back into the natural rhythm of your breath. And just observing the effects of the breath work, just letting the breath work wash over your insides, wash over your consciousness. You're welcome to remain with your eyes closed, or if you'd like to open your eyes for our reading this morning. Today I'm going to read from the Agape International Spiritual Center's monthly book of readings called Inner Visions. Each day has a different reading, so I'm going to read the reading for today. The reading for today is called In the Beginning, and there's a quote from the Bible that says, "For unto us a child is born," the Holy Bible, Isaiah 9:6. There is only one thing happening under the sun, and this has always been the case: the quest for tender remembrance of one's innate source. Just imagine every falter, every hurt, every tear, and every laughter, thrill and delight, all point to the crystallized truth. We are here for God's glory and revelation. All roads lead to the source. When we venture within, we connect to that which sourced us, birthed us, and continues to celebrate us. Now, if only we could remember this indefatigable connection, regardless of circumstances and conditions. For there is tremendous comfort in realizing all things work together for our highest good and resplendent grace. We become brave, daring, fearless. We create, we heal ourselves as well as others, and when necessary, we retreat and self-soothe. In search of solace, we are always attempting to return to the innocence of the womb, a time when we wanted for nothing, as we were able to clearly discern that all of our needs, and then some, were met. A time when we rejoiced in our solitude, for we realized we are never alone. We luxuriated in the palpitations of our mother's heartbeat and radiated in the awareness of our connection to the undulating waves ferrying us into bliss. How good it felt to be contained in this fashion. How safe it felt to be graced and to grace our way into existence. As we cocooned, we allowed, and as we allowed, we were born. In the waking world, there are sweet reminders of our previous sequestered life in the womb. The rushing sound of the seashell, the crashing of waves, the gush of a geyser. We hear these and are calmed, pacified, for they hearken back to our first home. In the stillness of the night, we remember. At dawn's first light, we recall life, safe at last. That's written by Karen Brailsford. There's an affirmation for today, and I'll put it in the comments when I'm done. when we're done meditating. The affirmation is, I am always connected to that which birthed me. I welcome life. I am the light. I am always connected to that which birthed me. I welcome life. I am the light. So just allowing that reading to move through you. As you close your eyes again. As we begin the process of moving closer to that which birthed us this morning, to that place of safety and wholeness within ourselves. We set our intentions to become so still and focused this morning that we feel the presence of God within our own being, that which birthed us out of itself. We come in contact with this divine love this morning. And we seek to feel this expression as our life. And so as we move into this practice this morning, you can use your breath as an anchor or a guide so that when you become aware that you're in the future, or in the past, or involved in a story, or a sensation, that the moment you notice, you can lovingly bring yourself back to some aspect of your breath to help re-anchor you in the present moment. You can turn your attention back to the divine over and over again. And we just do this as many times as we need to, without judgment. Unconditional love, we bring ourselves back as many times as we need to this morning. With every breath, we feel the womb of God surround us. We feel closer to this divinity within ourselves. That place that is untouched by outside circumstances, that place within yourself that is always whole and perfect and complete. With every breath, we move closer to this place within. If your mind feels busy this morning, or you're noticing agitation in your body, just allow it to be so. Just allow yourself to be exactly as you are. And you can notice the thoughts, the sensations, the busyness. Acknowledge that it exists and and then see if you can allow it to just move through, to pass through. As if you were watching a cloud pass through the sky or someone walk by. Just observing, acknowledging, and allowing it to move through. Noticing where is your attention. Lovingly guide yourself back. Using your breath, re-anchor yourself in the here and now. Lovingly choose to come back to the divine nature of your being right now. so as we begin to close out our meditation this morning, take a moment to be in gratitude for this practice. To be in gratitude for the simplicity of this practice, the availability of this practice, how profound this practice is. Just be in gratitude and thanksgiving for the ability to have this time. And then take a moment to be in gratitude for any insights, any shifts, any awakenings. Big or small this morning. Be in gratitude. Give thanks for these shifts, for these awarenesses. Take a full breath in together. And easefully exhale out. And as you're ready, you can allow your eyes to open and bring your vision back into your space. All right, you guys, thank you so much for joining me this morning. I am grateful for each and every one of you for being willing to do this work and commit to this time and for showing up to practice meditation together. Thank you. And if you are struggling with meditation or feel challenged right now with spiritual practices, that's okay. And just remember, I had a discussion with a patient the other day. I do a lot of nutrition work in my practice, and we were talking about eating and what to eat. And she's having a hard time right now eating healthfully because it's the holidays, and there's just more stress and more snacks around that are not necessarily healthy. But what I said to her was, you know, let that be okay. Know that 80% of the time you're doing your work and the right thing, and that 20% of the time that you eat something that's maybe not on the list, it's fine. And you can, it's not all or nothing. You can always come back to a healthy choice, the right choice for your body. So if you have a day where it's a bit off, the next day you wake up and you recommit. And it's the same with spiritual practices, that there may be some times where it feels like you're not connected, or maybe a little bit stale, or maybe you don't do it for a while, but just know that you can always recommit. You can always the next morning or the next breath, you know, just come back to the practice, any part of the practice, the breath work, journal writing, prayer, meditation, and you can just choose to start again. You can choose to come back again, and you can do it any way you'd like. There's no right way to do it. It's just that we make that choice to come back when we've forgotten or when it feels hard. All right, you guys, I love you so much. I am grateful for you, and I will be back Friday morning, 8 a.m. for our meditation time. All right, thanks for joining me this morning. Bye. Pepper says bye too.